come from my faith, the source of my faith is always God and always will be God. You know, the time where I used to face my trials and tribulations, when I didn't see something, I would want to give up. When I didn't see something, I would want to stop and turn back. But I had to realize, you know, as I started to grow, you know, I had to believe that God has already done what he said he would do.
That's it.
Even if I didn't see it, even if there was nothing that was showing that things were turning around, I had to already believe that it already turned around so I can be comfortable. Because I always had that in the back of my mind and I wasn't moving forward. So she just really touched my heart. You know, we had a conversation today, and I'm telling you, babe, put God first. Put your trust in God and it's going to be all right. I'm telling you, put your trust in God, it's going to be all right. Because all of you that have been through a test and have came out with a testimony know what I'm talking about.
That's right.
That's everybody. Because my testimony every day is just waking up and taking my first breath. This is one of my, the first pieces I ever wrote. Pray God will just think through my minds right now, speak through my vocals, because really, to tell you the truth, I don't really understand it, but I have faith. I look at my wristband, my breast doesn't work, I wear this band, it says faith. I'm going to have faith that, you know, when I begin to recite this poem, it's going to go the way God wants it to go, not the way that I want it to go. Because really, I'm not going to perform right now. This is what I'm going to do. I'm here to minister. You know, the words that I say, you know, the words that God's using me to say right now may touch somebody. So it's not about me. Even if I wanted to do this poem, my plans always has to be revised because there's someone that I always put first. I'm just in the passenger seat. So if he tells me to go left, I'm going. So without further ado, this one is called The Road to Redemption. The road to redemption seems so long, but no matter what, I've had to stand strong. Day by day, with no time for play, I find myself in a place that I'm forced to stay. Father, please take my hand and guide me through this journey that will lead to the promised land. It's true what you told me in Matthew, that I must enter through the narrow gates. But my heart seems to try to impede my fate. Lord, I need your help before it's too late. I need your victory, I need your applaud. My world is changing, my road is getting broad. And broad is the road that leads to destruction. I'm losing my mind like a volcano eruption. I'm being backed into a wall, I try to stand tall, but I continue to fall. Father, please don't go away. Father, can you hear me? I need your love today. I'm on my knees. I'm begging you, please, to heal me and my family. Give us the strength that we need to face this ambitious reality. We've been separated by different lifestyles. No more happy days, no more nice smiles. Just new trials and new tribulations. Fingers being pointed, new allegations. How can we be family? No more family time, no more family vacations. But we call ourselves family with no foundation, no conversations. The only thing that makes us family is that we're held together by male generations.
Wow.
Thank you, Lord. No more family time, no more family vacations. His fingers being pointed, new allegations, just new frustrations. But we are fruit from the same tree. You know, birds of a feather must flock together, but we're divided by seasons with different weather. One's windy, one's rainy, one's sunny, and one's cold. But I'll never allow myself to be sold. I'm a transformer, there's more to me than meets the eye. It's too early for me not to try. I came too high not to fly. It's too early for me to cry. It's too early for me to die. I came too far to say goodbye. I've been on this road since March, April, May, June, July, and still I can't comply. I don't know why it's so hard for me to be the Lord's ally. I'm too blessed to be stressed, depressed, compressed. This world is the poison, it's too big for me to digest. I said I'm too blessed to be stressed, depressed, compressed. This world is the poison, it's too big for me to digest. But my Lord Tell me that he will put me to a test that I'll be able to contest because I'm the best of the best. I will continue to travel down my road until I reach the end of my quest. And the Lord told me with my mouth, thou shalt confess, and I shall be free from all sin. In a life without sin, I'm bound to win. I'm bound to overcome the things of this society. I'm bound to put my trust and faith in God because he will rely on me to stand up and fight and to be the light that illuminates the helping hand that will one day lead his people to the promised land where we can all sing, now behold the Lamb, the precious Lamb of God who died for all our sins so that we can live abroad and stay away from all the world's extrinsic frauds. You see me? I'm an African. First generation born American. December 5th, 1991 is when my life began. I'm a natural born leader, a proficient mind reader. I was destined to be a hero until my number one became adjacent to a zero, which made me a 10. But no matter how hard my road may be, I will travel until I reach the end. The Lord told me that it wouldn't be easy, but he also told me that he wouldn't leave me. Listen to what I'm saying, you gotta believe me. You gotta put your trust and faith in God. You gotta pick up your Bible and read it for what it's worth. It's the believer's instructions before leaving earth. And it doesn't matter what anybody else says, because at the end of the day, the judge is God. And why is he the judge? Because he determines who wins or loses, not your opponent. So with every chance you get, you better own it. Because God determines who wins or loses, not your opponent. So with every chance you get, you gotta own it. You gotta stake the darkness and let in the light. Even in the night, you still gotta shine bright. You see, my road, it seemed so dark. Until Christ made a remark that gave it a spark, and then my road became illuminated. But right now, right here, it's only through the grace of God that I can finally say, I made it. Thank you.